Hello everyone, it's Lewis Dyer here, and today I'm going to take you through a quick speed painting piece. Basically how I start them and the kind of techniques I use while painting. So let's get started. First I create a new layer and right click on the canvas to bring up the brush panel. And I normally go for a soft round brush to begin with, just to lay down any random colours that I feel like. So the aim here is to pretty much just cover the canvas with colour to get rid of all the white basically, and just do random strokes. I held down R to rotate the canvas. It can help sometimes to look at your canvas at different angles to see if you can see anything developing. But at the moment there's nothing here, so just keep adding more and more brush strokes. So now I'm going to use the mixer brush tool, and I'm basically going to be adding a bunch of texture to the piece early on. This is something you'd normally do towards the end of the painting, but as this is going to be a quick 1 hour speed painting, I'm just going to chuck everything down right now. Sometimes you can find like an idea or an inspiration for a piece really quite early, but sometimes it takes a while for something to appear. So I've kind of decided this dark object right here is going to be some kind of portrait. So now that I have a basic idea, I just start rendering the form. So this is only going to be a 1 hour painting, so nothing has to be perfect really, as long as people can recognize that it's a face, then I'll be happy. So we're 8 minutes in at the moment, so I've actually got quite a lot of time still to perhaps add a new element into the painting. So what I'm aiming for at the moment is just to make everything as clear as possible. So when you zoom out, you can still see basically what the picture is. A good tool or trick to use is the navigator. It creates a little thumbnail in the corner, so you can for some reason mine's disappearing. There we go. So I'm still using the soft round brush tool just because I want the elements to basically fade into each other still. Later on I'm going to use the hard round brush to define details. So I realized the reason why it was hard to, why the picture wasn't so clear as a thumbnail is because the character and the background were both very saturated, but changing the brush blending mode to saturation and choosing the color black and then painting over the saturated areas, it basically desaturates it, which means now that this character is like popping out towards us more, and it makes it easier to see. But if we ever wanted to add saturation back, we just basically go to a fully saturated color and start painting over it again. But as you see, you get a slightly different result. It's pretty cool. So now I'm basically halfway through, and the piece is looking pretty done already for speed painting, so I think I'm actually going to expand it and add a new element. So this area is not going to contain face anymore, but using the mixer brush tool, I managed to keep a lot of the same colours. and potentially paint something new. So I think I'm actually going to paint a bird in this side of the painting. This is all from imagination, so it's probably not going to look amazing, but still, as long as you can tell it's a bird, I will be happy. So with 15 minutes to go, I'm going to start adding a bit more texture to this new side of the painting. Yeah, okay, I think we're pretty much done now. So this was just a random speed painting from out of the blue. I hope you enjoyed watching. I hope you probably learned some stuff. And if you wanted to learn more, I've got online courses where I teach the essentials of digital painting. I'm currently developing an advanced course as well, which is turning out to be amazing, but I'm going to share some more information about soon. So yeah, thanks for watching.